Live. Oh, yeah. Do we need that? We got us right here. That's going to distract us if we look at that.
Hey, y'all.
Hey, y'all. Hey, if you can hear us okay, give us a thumbs up. Say hi. please let us know you are here. We sure appreciate that. Man, we got some good stuff to talk about tonight. I'm fired up about it. Yeah, I think, you know, when I get out and I'm in that dirt, I think I'm more fired up than I am any time. I think that's part of what does it for me.
Well,
and it was a beautiful day to do it.
And you know what's coming.
Yeah.
What you're doing, so.
Yeah.
That always helps.
Sure enough. So once again, if you are on here, leave us, put a comment out there, let us know you're alive and well with us, and you can hear us okay. I think I saw my aunt was on here earlier. I love it when she comes.
Mona?
Miss Mona, yes, mm-hmm. ma'am. Mona saw the picture of the tomato soup.
Oh.
The other day, she was like, what did you put in that?
Yeah, tomato soup is canned and on the shelf for whenever we want some grilled cheese sandwiches.
That's right.
And it was yummy.
We got blessed with some really late season tomatoes.
Hey, Kaylee Corbin.
Oh, awesome. And there was, we put tomatoes in the freezer and then we canned crushed tomatoes and then we made tomato soup. It's actually just a really thick sauce right now.
He put some in a jar for me to, I had to sip on it.
Spice it up a
little
bit.
Really, really good.
A little bit of salt, a little bit of thyme. It was good.
Really good.
Yeah, waiting for a good cold day.
Or evening or whatever.
That's right.
I might just get it out tomorrow. Who knows?
Right. So we are glad you are here with us. No coffee tonight. I am having having broth.
Mm.
Chicken broth.
He's got it all seasoned up.
It sure is good.
And I have my hibiscus tea, which I don't know, you can't see it, but it's
the color is
really
amazing.
Red. It's really amazing.
It really is.
And typically you don't really need too much sweetener with hibiscus tea because the hibiscus flower is so sweet.
Mm-hmm.
But it's good stuff.
All right, kick it off, lady.
All right.
Start talking about our stuff.
Well, first,
let's see.
We have five people on here, and we would like to start with thanking you all for sharing our posts and our videos and all that stuff. So we're going to kick off this live with taking a minute to hit the share button and share this with your friends.
Right
Could
now.
Could you do that right now? Yeah. We'll wait. We won't talk.
We're not going anywhere. We'll just sit here and sip our broth and our tea.
That would be awesome if y'all could do that.
Do I need to put some music on while we wait?
We're ramping up for holiday season, and we can't thank y'all enough for jumping on these lives with us and calling us and messaging and liking and sharing and all that stuff during the week. But this is a big... You know, this is a big thing for us to, it's a big thing for him too, to be getting on a live and having a conversation. You know, I honestly didn't ever think that this would happen, but it's pretty cool and it's exciting and it's a great thing. So go ahead and hit that share button. We love it. We love y'all. We love that you support us. And if you can't, the biscuit tea. Steve-o. Hey, Kim. If for some reason you can't support us by buying our products or, you know, things like that, or you live out of state, share. Hit that share button. That is, like,
huge
right now.
Yeah.
We, Mr. Man here did a TikTok. I think I shared it last week on building those raised beds. And just from that TikTok, I can't even tell you how many likes and shares and follows and subscriptions that we got just from that one TikTok, because I think we told you it was like 46,000 views.
Crazy.
It was crazy. So, if you have done that, thank you so much. And if you haven't yet, go ahead and do that. We'll wait just another couple seconds and we'll get on with our show.
Let's tell them about supper.
Look, we just ate.
Man.
Had to get some seasons out of my teeth.
So if you've been around for a little while, You know that we raised our own meat chickens right there in the backyard. We live in a subdivision, and this is our urban homestead. We raised meat chickens right in the backyard. Well, we pulled out one of those chickens tonight. And
how much did it weigh?
It was 7.2 pounds. It was a big
one. It was a big one.
Big old chicken.
No, we did not eat the whole thing.
Yeah.
But he has
a picture.
I don't
have that picture.
Oh, you didn't put it on? Okay, I have it on my phone. Maybe I can put it up to the screen. Took a picture of it.
Yeah, I didn't put it on there.
Amazing.
But yeah, what an awesome.
Beautiful.
It just doesn't taste like.
Let's see. I can't tell.
I don't know if I can see that or not.
It's going to be a delay, so hang on a second. Oh, there we go. Can you see how beautiful that is? And let me tell you something. Ain't nothing like it.
It just don't taste like grocery store chicken.
What did somebody say to us today? Somebody said, I wish that I could enjoy my food. Or what was the comment? I think it might have been Kevin. Because we were talking about how much we love our food that we grow, and I can't think of the word. I'll think about it, and I'll probably just squirrel it in the middle of something.
Right.
But, to know that we raised them, we fed them, we took care of them, and we cooked them and prepared them the way we want, but they were amazing. The chicken is amazing.
Right.
That's all there is to it. And speaking of that, we are getting new birds.
Yes.
We shared that with you.
They're supposed to be here the week of October the 18th.
Yeah, so we're looking at like three or four weeks.
Yeah.
And we put out let y'all know that we were looking for a few families to go in with us. So you can take some chicken home to your freezer.
Right.
Especially in this climate that we're in. And we really could use some commitments.
Yeah, we want to partner with you.
Yeah.
From beginning to end,
mm-hmm.
You know, if you want to come over here and look at the chicks every day, that's fine. You know, we'll take care of the feeding them, and we'll take care of picking up the food. We'll take care of everything from 3-day-old chick to the day that we process them. We'll handle it.
Yeah.
And no what problem. We would like for you to do is partner with us and make a commitment to take some of these chickens home with you after they're processed. We want you to be part of the processing also.
And it's really not as bad as you think.
Yeah.
It really isn't.
It's not. It's not. It's a humane process.
Yeah. It's 17 birds. It took us, what?
3 hours.
3 hours for the three of us to do.
There was three of us.
And it was quite an interesting situation. He was kind of worried about that me, but man,
what
a champ. It was done. It was really cool.
About, honestly, I couldn't keep up with the two people who were doing the evisceration.
Yeah, it was kind of funny.
Yeah, I just could not
we
keep up.
We were just hanging around waiting. So
that's that. If you want to partner with us, get in touch with us. Leave us a comment here. And we'll get in contact with you, or send us a message, or if you don't have send us a message. If you've got our phone number, pick
call
up the phone and
call
us.
Call us. We're looking to kind of get some commitments within the next week or so, if we can. Just let us know. I know there's some people that are not online tonight that have told me they wanted to, so I'll be sending out messages for that in case you see this on replay.
Right.
Speaking of replay, if you're watching this on replay, I know the ones of you that are here are live. Can you write in the comments, hashtag replay, let us know that you're there so we know that you watched. Because last week's video, I don't know how many views, but there was a lot of views afterwards.
Right.
So we know you guys are out there. Just let us know.
Right.
We're not going to call you out or anything.
We just want
to know who's supporting us and let y'all know that we love y'all and we thank you. What's next?
I don't know.
So we have moringa trees in our yard, and we've shared that a few times with you, and some of you are probably like, what's a moringa? It is called the tree of life in some countries. It's also called the drumstick plant, but you can eat the whole tree from the leaves, the bark, to the roots. So he's showing you a picture, some pictures of some of our...
That's the plant.
There's the plant right there. We have two in the front. We have seven or eight in the back that I planted out in the ground, and I had to save them from all the water, yeah. but they're growing like crazy, and I'm bringing in moringa every day. And there's, most of you probably don't know much about it, but there's some of the people that we know, some friends that have come out here and know exactly what it is. And I'm just going to share with you a little bit about this plant and what it's helped with and different things. It is native to Asia, Africa, and South America, where it's hot. A lot of people in Florida, South Florida, grow it as a business. I found that on YouTube. So it is grown in the United States, even though some people can't believe it because it's not hot enough here. Let me tell you a little story. I tried to plant these things. They would not germinate. I was thinking, I'm just going to stop. And then it started getting hot. And the minute it started getting hot, they started sprouting. And it didn't click to me this season that that's what happened last year. And I was kind of distraught because I use it as a tea. I take the leaves, I dry them, put them in a tea blend. I have not tried selling them yet, but they are going to be offered. And that was one of the pictures that he showed. I actually have them in leaf form, dried leaf form. Literally, I take the branches and hang them to dry and in the house, and within a couple days they're all dry. Can you go back to that other picture where the two? Mm-hmm. I have them in a leaf form, and I have powdered them because sometimes I will put them in my smoothies, put them in my shakes, things like that. So you can see on that picture, the larger jar is the leaves. They'll go into tea blends that I'm getting ready to make for the holiday season. And then the powder is something that we're looking at selling out to you guys if you want to try it. The other picture is Brian had a great idea while we were at the market on Saturday of putting it in these tins. And look how cute it is. It's a half ounce. Let me tell you, there's 10 teaspoons in there, and that's a serving.
That's the recommended serving is a teaspoon. Yeah.
I have seen other posts say that you can take up to a tablespoon. You know, it's up to you. It's really up to you and how fine the powder is. The powder is, of course, going to be, you're going to need more of that than the leaves if you're using the leaves in a tea. But, you know, we can talk about that, too, if you're interested.
Right.
I have some friends that make a lot of skincare products. And moringa is really good for your skin. It contains a variety of proteins, minerals. I am reading my notes because I can't remember everything. B1, it's the thiamine, zinc, magnesium. Those two words sound familiar to you?
Yeah.
I was kind of shocked. I just read that tonight. I've read a lot about moringa over the past 2 years, but I just read that. Is there a bug on me?
It was mosquito.
All right. There's a few things that it has been known to treat. And I'm not a doctor, but I'm just reading what I read online, and I've known some of these things. It fights bacterial issues, which some of us have, can reduce the amount of glucose in the blood for diabetics, has properties in it that helps with asthma. So there's quite a few things that, thanks for putting me back up.
You're welcome.
There, that this plant can help with. But to start with, tea blends. So I have kind of a list of tea blends that I'm working on, especially for the holiday, and moringa will be a part of that, and I'm kind of excited about that. So, yeah, that's my little moringa tutorial.
Awesome.
So if anybody's interested, please let us know. I am going to be packaging up some more, the leaves. It is coming to the end. I'm probably going to be putting those plants in the greenhouse so they don't die off on these cool nights.
Right.
How about these cool nights?
Wow.
Yeah, they're really nice. Windows are open.
Hey, you know what cool nights mean?
What?
Football!
That comes from the man who doesn't watch
football.
I don't watch football.
But, so, true story. We have changed our packaging for our salsa. We're not doing the plastic bins anymore. This is a shippable salsa. It is canned. So we could ship it to anybody that wants our Homestead salsa.
Yeah. Isn't that pretty? Doesn't that look nice?
It is so good, y'all.
Let me tell you. It's good.
This one's pretty spicy.
It is spicier than...
I got to make some mild.
I would, yes, because Melissa wants some mild.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
This is so flavorful. It doesn't get you right away. You take a couple chips, eat some, and then...
And if it's not spicy enough for you, we can add in the funk.
Yes.
I've got a four pepper blend. You see there on the picture.
See that little picture.
Yeah, that stuff right there is good. And you can add that to that sauce and it'll just take it to another place.
So warning about that little package, we just had a little conversation about this today. If you use it, when you use it and you get to the bottom, shake it up real good because it could be the bigger flakes of ghost pepper in the bottom.
It might settle on you.
A friend of our son decided to sprinkle some on his eggs and he got the whole power of the ghost.
Yeah, it hit him pretty hard.
Yeah. Somebody asked me the other day if this salsa was hot because she likes hot stuff and I said ghostly. She thought that was funny. So that was a little pun.
We were a little dark there.
Oh, it's not dark yet. It's still pretty bright out.
Yeah. So we've got salsa that is shippable.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're not local or you want us to ship it to us, ship it to you, just go to our website, PruittHomestead.com, place an order, and we'll get it right in the mail for
we'll
you.
We'll get it in within the next day or so, depending on what day the order comes in. Shipped out some tea to California last week to a friend of mine that ordered. So thankful for that order. I had given her a little sample and she was loving it. So she placed an order.
So do we have any collard green lovers on with us right now? Let's see who all we got on there.
We got Julia. I'm on there. Steve. Kim may be still there.
Okay. So this week I planted collards. And we got two rows of collards. We got a lot of collards planted. I've got 50 plants spread throughout the homestead. So there's not going to be a lack of collard greens.
That is true.
This year.
Let me just shout out Claudia. Yes, we are in Pooler. And you just send us a message. If you're close enough, we do travel around a little bit. So we can meet halfway or deliver whatever works for you. So send us a message through Pruitt Homestead and we'll get with you.
So, yeah, if you're a collard lover, excuse me, get ready because it's coming and there's going to be an abundance. And we are going to start making our collard dip this year.
Shut up.
As soon as the collards start coming in.
Start speaking in tongues. It's so good.
I got a tickle in my throat. Well,
get rid of that.
Yeah.
So good.
Collard dip. But we'll have raw collards also, and we like for you to just come to the house and we'll pick them right then and there.
Right.
Take them home, cook them. And that's fresh, right?
We may bring some to markets, but it seems that if we pick them fresh when you're here, it's a lot better
for
you.
They just hold up a whole lot better.
They do. And some people are just skeptical about buying fresh vegetables like that out at markets.
Yeah.
Speaking of markets, we're just kind of flowing into all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
Market is starting to buck up this holiday season. Between Ellen Claire's and Falkville, that's where we'll be this Saturday. And there's a car show out in Georgetown next month. All kinds of markets all over the place. So we're going to kind of be everywhere. And we will definitely let y'all know where we're going to be, especially if we're coming to your area. Of course, I don't know where everybody lives, but if you see us, you know, posting about it, that's where we'll be. Just holler at us and say, hey, when are you going to be here? Right. When are you going to be there? Right. Like tomorrow, I happen to be going out to Victory Drive to check on our honey. So if there's somebody out there that needs something or wants something, just give me a call tonight. I won't be leaving until about 9:30 tomorrow morning, and I could carry it with me.
That's right.
So that works for us sometimes. Sometimes it doesn't. It just depends on our schedule. So just we can work it out with you.
This Saturday coming, we're going to be at Ellen Claire's
right.
In Falkville. Yeah.
That's at the
Hometown Auto.
Hometown Auto, yeah. right up from Parker's. That's right there in Falkville, up from 17. We'll be there.
Let's give the Hometown Auto a shout out.
Yeah.
Oh, they're great folks.
Yeah.
I tell you what, dependable, reliable. You do need to schedule an appointment.
Yes, you do. They're busy, and that's amazing.
They are busy right now, and it's real simple. There's a shortage of cars. People are getting a lot of car work done. Call them, Hometown Auto, schedule an appointment. Mm-hmm. Go get your oil changed. Yeah. Go visit them. Check them out. It's good to build local relationships.
It is. And if you haven't been to Ellen Claire, they are part of that same family. They have some amazing shampoo bars, all kinds of soaps and oils and things like that. go check them out. That's where I get my shampoo bar and my stuff for my hair. So really nice. Really nice people too. Christmas is coming.
Christmas is coming.
And you're going to see some things. If you've been checking out our website, you're going to see some things on there for Christmas gifts. You know, last year we did baskets and I kind of stuck with one theme, but this year I have a list of different things to put together to make things a little easier for y'all. You know, you have a family member that likes hot stuff, just a little hint, girl stuff, boy stuff, you know, stuff like all kinds of goodies. So, yes, ma'am, Claudia, just get with us. So that'll be coming soon. It's coming up fall weather and pumpkin time. And speaking of that, I want to mention something about that too. And we know that people like to shop early. And what's better to shop from than your friends and family's home businesses?
That's right.
If we can shop local instead of big box in the climate that we're in, it would mean so much to those families. Because you have families that are doing this like we're doing, or doing some kind of home business that putting food on their kids' table.
That's right.
And
you have so many people through the quarantine and all the changes in going on in America right now. There's a lot of people that are saying, you know, corporate world, you're just not working out for me.
Yeah.
And so they're starting home-based businesses. Yep. And it's amazing. Or they already have home-based businesses that they're going to expand on. I was just over at Jack's Old Sawmill today, and Chris said, man, we're expanding. We're growing. And I love it. I am so excited.
Sorry. We have a bird.
He's mad.
That is really loud.
He's
and,
mad at us.
And I don't know where he is now, but he was just sitting there on the wood. And he's up there.
She's mad at us.
Oh, something's going on.
I bet there's a nest or something.
Whew, it's loud. Yeah. Sorry. Old Jack Sawmill.
Yeah, they're expanding. They're growing. And we're excited about that.
Yeah.
There's a lot of local businesses that you need to build relationships with.
Yes, yes. It's a really cool thing. And if that's something you're interested in looking into, doing your own business, look into it, because it might be something that you need, even if it's plan B these days.
Have we talked about the t-shirts yet?
Not yet.
Okay, let's talk about those right now. This is important, folks. This is really, really important. So, Michelle designed our bee for the honey bottle.
Yeah.
And we are doing an exclusive one-time offer of a Be Kind t-shirt offered through our website. And we are promoting Michelle Medina.
Yeah, we are.
Yeah. And so, what we want you to do, go to the website, order this shirt.
That would be amazing.
It's all pre-orders. Get your size in. We've got about 15 days left for you to get it ordered.
We're halfway through the campaign.
That's right. So we need you to get your shirt ordered, because when 30 days is up, we're going to order them, and that's going to be it.
That's going to be it.
And
we know a lot of you were looking for them and waiting for them, so here they are.
Right, right. Christmas gifts there.
Yeah, right there.
Right there.
I mean, it's cool. You know, first of all, you're supporting us. You're supporting Michelle. You're supporting what we're doing here and what we're trying to share with others. But it's a really cool drawing. And we'll have next year, we're looking at doing some other artist spotlights, maybe more of Michelle's, maybe some others. It just depends.
That's right.
But and not just shirts either, different things. So keep an eye out for that. But go check out the website. If you don't have it, we'll post it again in this thread, but it's all over our Pruitt Homestead Facebook page.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
What else we got? It's getting dark on us.
It is. Well, I had written down the salsa too, but you brought
got
that up all together.
Let's go through a few pictures. Yeah. I took a few pictures today.
You guys got any questions while he's going through pictures?
Yeah. Stuff is growing. This is Swiss chard. If you've never eaten Swiss chard, it's a lot like beet greens. As a matter of fact, it's got the other name for it is silver beet. So it's a really super tender green. You saute it with a little bit of bacon grease, and it's amazing. The stems are edible. It's not bitter at all. Very, very mild tasting, and it's growing, and we're going to have it abundance.
I do want to do a little shout out.
Okay.
To Jacqueline's daughter's 13th birthday.
Amen.
She's so beautiful.
I love it.
So happy birthday, sweetie.
Happy
I know
birthday.
I told you today, but just thought I'd call you out on the show.
Hey, you want to sing it?
I don't know.
Okay, we won't sing.
We won't sing.
That might embarrass her.
We won't sing.
That might be a little bit.
But all her kids, they sit and watch the show. They're probably doing happy birthday stuff with her tonight, so
right.
They're not on tonight. But I know Jacqueline. She'll be
That's
in
right.
front of the computer watching it later. So,
cabbage.
Ooh.
We are growing lots of cabbage. This particular variety is called Savoy cabbage. I know you've seen it in the grocery store. It's kind of crinkly. It's cabbage. And we like to make sauerkraut.
Yes.
Out of our cabbage.
Sauerkraut.
Lots of sauerkraut. And I saw a recipe last night where we can coleslaw.
Oh.
I know. I was blown away. I'm
All
not
right.
even joking. They say can your coleslaw.
Huh.
When you're ready to eat it, take it out, rinse it off. And then put your stuff in there that you like in your coleslaw.
Oh, okay.
I thought that was genius.
That is.
Yeah.
Very cool.
So there's that. What else have I got?
We have a friend that's watching tonight. She is a friend that I met at the auction. Her name is Julia. And she is such a handy little thing. She makes all kinds of cool door hanging things and holiday treats. Not treats. Holiday... things to dress up your house. She is on tonight and she is trying to start her own business too. And I saw her at Friendly's last week and she's got the cutest stuff that she's making.
The wreaths?
Yes,
the wreaths
and everything.
Yeah.
So maybe Julia, you could, if you have a Facebook page, you can post it on this thread and that way, you know, anybody's interested, they could go click on it and take a look at your items.
Yes.
I know you post some.
Yes. And these, they are beautiful, beautiful.
Yeah,
beans.
They really are. Hey, Harley, how's everybody?
That's just a raised bed picture. Let's see what else. I think that's it as far as pictures I've got. Let's take some questions because it's getting dark.
It is getting dark.
Let's see if anybody has questions.
You guys have any questions for us? I'm looking.
These days are getting shorter and shorter and shorter. We're probably going to have to.
That looks really dark. It's not really that dark because I'm looking at us.
He's trying to lighten it up.
See, look how light we are on the iPad. We might, while y'all are thinking about some questions, if you have any, let us know. I'll keep an eye out. Yesterday, I had a conversation with a friend, and she's a homeschool mom, and she's thinking about doing some kind of class for her kids and the neighboring homeschool kids for planting and gardening. And she asked me if I'd be interested in doing something like that. So that was pretty exciting.
And we do want to do that. We would love to have a whole homeschool class come to the property here and take a tour.
Yeah.
So we want to encourage other people to do what we're doing here. We are growing 80% of all the vegetables that we consume, we're doing it right here on this piece of property. And now we're doing chickens also. So our hope would be that we could get some students over here to see how it's done, encourage them, maybe even put some plants in their hand or help them at home do the same thing.
And I just want to add to that, it's sometimes they're not planned. Sometimes plants grow and they're not planned. I am looking at our compost pile right here and it has some kind of potato vine coming out of it. But the other day, Brian says to me, come here, look at this flower. What does that look like? So we have cucumbers growing out of our compost pile.
Late season cucumbers.
Transplants. I don't know. What do you call them? Volunteers.
Volunteers. Yeah.
So we put the trellis up over it so it has something to grow on, and it is more than halfway up the side of the trellis. I'll take a picture tomorrow when the sun is out and post
it. Asked, my monarch caterpillars have run out of milkweed. What else do they eat?
Oh my goodness.
Buddy, I don't know nothing about monarch
you
butterflies.
You better duck, go that one. I don't know.
There's been a huge migration occurring.
Yeah. I have seen a lot of butterflies. I don't know if they're actually monarchs or not, but more flowers that you have. But yeah, well, look that up. Let us know.
We'll be praying for them.
Oh, there's our little friend.
What is that?
Was that a hummingbird?
I don't know what it was.
Steve actually brought us a plant to church last week. I don't remember what it's called now, but I got it in dirt, and it is...
It's looking good.
It is, and so I'm keeping it moist, keeping water underneath of it so it never gets dry, and I'm checking on it like a child. So it does have a little flower bud that's getting ready to come up, so I'm hoping that that happens. So, is there anything else you guys want to know? Because it's getting dark. We don't want to be keeping y'all too long. But we want to thank you all for coming on. If you have not shared, if you were not on in the beginning of the program, please hit that share button. Even though it's the end of the program, they can watch it on replay.
That's right.
You know, you may not think that that's a big deal, but it is a huge support for us, for our channel, for our homestead, for everything. And it's just a really easy way to support your friends.
That's right.
So we have a friend, Sherry. She has Fusion, the coffee.
Fusion Coffee Roasters.
Fusion Coffee Roasters. Yep. And I'm not telling you a lie. She shares every post Pruitt Homestead
and
post.
And it's a huge blessing.
It is. So, I mean, we could be getting followers from her. I don't know.
Yeah.
So she's a blessing. Her goat is getting ready to kid, and I'm excited because it was supposed to be last week, and I may be able to go and see it.
Steve said that's a ballroom gown flower.
Oh, okay.
That's right.
A ballroom gown flower, and it looks just like
that. It's amazing.
There was a flower on it, but of course, you know, flowers don't last forever, so I got some seeds. All right, y'all.
It's time.
It is time. If you haven't tried our tea or coffee yet, you need to let us know because it's yummy.
Go to PruittHomestead.com, place an order there, we'll ship it out to you. Or there's an option for local pickup. You can just click that and it won't charge you any shipping.
Yep.
And then we'll get in contact with you to make arrangements to come by and pick it up, or we'll go meet you, whatever it might be.
And if you want to come by for some coffee or take a little tour, please come out. We would love to have you. All right.
All right. We love y'all.
Love y'all.
We'll
see
you soon.
See you next week.